Hi everyone, this is Chris Jagasia, the CEO of OftClass, and this is our first video in our series of videos about how to get your ESL school online. Just a quick background, we've been helping ESL teachers and ESL schools teach online for the better part of the last 6 years. Obviously, it's been really busy over the last month or so, so we thought we'd make this series of videos to help you get your ESL schools online. We're going to be going over in this series, we're going to be going over four key pieces of infrastructure that you're going to have to make a decision around to get your ESL school online, to get your online ESL venture up. The great news is that none of these are particularly hard to find, and they're all kind of commoditized pieces of infrastructure, which means there's lots of options and lots of low-cost options. So that's what we're really going to be focusing on in this series. But before we get into those four key pieces of infrastructure, I wanted to do a quick video about the concept of bootstrapping. Now, if you've never heard of bootstrapping, basically it's a startup term. And in the startup world, what bootstrapping means is not raising any outside capital or outside financing. So basically building your software company yourself and getting it online and finding users and building a business out of it. The concept of bootstrapping from kind of the startup world can easily be applied to everybody we've been chatting to who really needs to quickly get their bricks and mortar ESL school online. We're going to want to bootstrap your online ESL venture. And what that really means is instead of going out and buying a really expensive software solution that does everything for you, like integrated payments, booking, content, all of that, which is going to be really expensive, what we want to do is we want to take existing tools that are either free or very low cost, and we want to combine them into a solution that gets your school online. We want to be really capital efficient. When you're the founder of a bootstrap software company, you become an expert at finding free tools that get you 95% of the way there and have effectively 0% of the cost. So instead of going out and buying like a really sexy solution, what we're going to be focusing on in these videos is being as capital efficient as possible and getting your online ESL venture up and running as quick as possible. So you might be thinking, oh my God, this is going to be so difficult. We're going to have like a booking system from here. We're going to have a scheduling system from here, payments over here, education infrastructure over here. None of it's going to be combined. And you know, when we've got 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 10,000 students learning on the platform, it's going to be so hard to manage. And the other kind of cliche from the startup world that I wanted to mention here is good problems to have. When you have so many students coming to your online ESL school to learn and everything just gets unmanageable, that is a very good problem to have because it means you got out the gate, you've built a, you know, a compelling learning experience for your ESL students, and it's so compelling that you've got so many students who want to learn that everything's getting unmanageable. At that point, that is the time to convert from your bootstrap low-cost solution to the really sexy solution. But what we're going to be focusing on in these videos is getting you out the gate, getting those four key pieces of infrastructure set up for as least amount of money as possible so that you can get out the gate and get to that good problems to have kind of point. So yeah, I hope you're going to join us as we go through the four key pieces of infrastructure that we need to make a decision on to get your ESL school online, and look forward to seeing you there.